Well, today we're focusing on the birth of Jesus and how he was born in a manger. Well, this is day 5 of us reading through the Christmas story together with Scripture. And my name is Pastor Daniel Williams, and I'm so glad that you're here with us as we are talking through and pondering the truths of Scripture together in community. If you have missed the previous days with us, man, we're posting all of the 12-day devotional videos on our website, redemptiondb.com, and you can check them all out there, and we'll post as we go. Well, in today's reading, we'll be reading from Luke chapter 2, verses 1-7, and meditating about the providence of God. Now, Luke says this in chapter 2, verse 1. In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration when Quintilius was governor of Syria, and all went to be registered, each to his own town. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth, to Judah, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and the lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. And while they were there, the time came for her to give birth, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them in the inn. You know, one of the great doctrines of the Bible is that God is sovereign. He has a plan and a purpose that will never be thwarted. In fact, Psalm 103:19 says, "The Lord has established his throne in heavens, and his sovereignty rules over it all." Another way of stating this truth is God is the creator of heaven and earth, and all that occurs in the universe takes place under his divine providence. That is God's sovereign guidance and control. God governs creation as a loving father working through all things together for his good. He is actively alive in our lives. And Romans 8:28 says, "We know that God causes all things to work together for good, for those who love God, to those who called according to his purpose." And here in this Christmas story, we see this truth shine bright. You see, we have made a cute Christmas scene out of this retelling of Jesus' birth that was actually a messy scene. It was full of frustration, of pain, of hardship. The reality of a manger or an inn was far from a mother's dream for her child. In fact, many scholars describe the common manger back then was made of stone, not necessarily wood. So it would be like you were laying your child in a grave, and these stone mangers were not sanitized, but rather full of old feed from animals. And it was anything from what Mary probably wanted for her firstborn son. It was almost as if God was specifically wanting this to happen. Because you know what? He did want it to happen. He was ruling behind the scenes. In fact, Proverbs 21 verse 1 tells us that the king's heart is a stream of water in the hand of the Lord. He turns it wherever he will. This was an unusual event that was happening in the world, and it was just so happened to be the time of Jesus' birth. Go figure. And what seemed to be a horrible inconvenience of traveling to Bethlehem from Nazareth was actually part of God's sovereignty, his providence, and his plan. You see, God had prophesied that the Messiah would be born in Bethlehem. Micah 5:2 says, "But you, O Bethlehem, who are too little to be even among the clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is to be the ruler of Israel, whose coming forth is from old, from ancient days." This is speaking of Jesus. What seems to be a big inconvenience to Joseph and Mary was actually a part of God's sovereign plan. He wanted people to know that Jesus was the anointed one, the Christ, the Savior of the world. And this is why he gave us these prophecies, so we would know beyond a shadow of a doubt. In fact, he gave many other prophecies about the Messiah that he would that we would see fulfilled in this text alone. There would be a virgin giving birth to a son. Isaiah 7:14 prophesies about that. He would be of the lineage or household of David. 2 Samuel 7:14 says that. And God even used the swaddling clothes to be assigned to the shepherds so they would know the Christ is the King. Luke 2:12 says, "And this will be a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." So was this a great scenario for Joseph and Mary? Absolutely not. It wasn't even the greatest scenario for Jesus himself. Imagine God becoming a man, and this is where he is born. Rather than a palace, he's in an inn. There wasn't even a room for him, and yet this was a part of God's plan. And we can look back at it now and glory at this amazing plan, but the people going through it at the time probably questioned God. Joseph and Mary probably wondered what in the world is going on. But be reminded today from this text that even though things may not go according to our plan, they will always go according to God's plan, and he will receive glory. We learn from this story that in this moment that this is not the end. And when we go through trials, we can know that God, well, he is always working.